Christ our life. Christ our life.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt, let them exalt the hearts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound the Lord our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods earth, a place with light from the eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, owing an end to rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of His glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the people.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the Word of God. Let us meditate on how God in His time past saved His people, and in these last days has sent His Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete the paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption. Please be seated for the reading of the Word.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness He called night. Thus, evening came, and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day, and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky." And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came, and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground."
are wonderful in the ordering of all your works. May those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the words, the world's creation in the beginning. Except that at the end of the ages, Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. And you, lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went around behind them. The column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them. So they came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed, without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit, all Pharaoh's horses and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of a fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic. And he so clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea, when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped, but the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. "I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot, he is cast into the sea." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
made undimmed in splendor even in our day. What you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as a salvation of the nation through the water of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright through Christ our Lord.
To the Lord for mercy, to our God.
pray. Almighty, never living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveil the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, growing at the prompting of your grace, to the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, when the house of Israel lived in their mind, in their land, they defied it by their conduct and deeds. Therefore, I poured out my fury upon them because of the blood that they had poured out on the ground, and because they defiled it with idols. I scattered them among the nations, dispersing them over foreign lands. According to their conduct and deeds, I judged them. But when they came among the nations, wherever they came, they served to profane my holy name, because it was said of them, These are the people of the Lord. Yet they had to leave their land. So I have relented because of my holy name, which the house of Israel profaned among the nations where they came. Therefore, to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, Not for your sakes do I act, house of Israel, but for the sake of my holy name, which you profaned among the nations to which you came. I will prove the holiness of my great name, profaned among the nations, in whose midst you have profaned it. Thus the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when in their sight I prove my holiness through you. For I will take you away from among the nations, gather you from all the foreign lands, and bring you back to your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, to cleanse you from all your impurities and from all your idols. I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and place a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your fathers. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you.
the whole church concerning the accomplished work of human salvation, which you planned from all eternity. May the whole world know and see that what was cast down is raised up, what has become old is now made new, and all things are restored to integrity through Christ, just as by him they came into being, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Just as Christ was raised from the dead. death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If, then, we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. They said to him, them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, he has been raised. Remember what he said to you while he was in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and to be crucified and raised on the third day." He remembered his words. Then he returned from the tomb and announced all these things to the 11 and all the others. The women were Mary Magdalene, Jonah, and Mary, the mother of James. The others who accompanied them also told this to the apostles, but their stories seemed like nonsense, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb, bent down and saw the burial cloth alone. Then he went home amazed at all that had happened. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy Easter to all of you, all those who come from points far and near to be with family and friends tonight. We wish you a great visit with your family and friends as we celebrate Easter night and tomorrow, and as we celebrate the next 50 days leading up to Pentecost. When it's time for you to go home, I wish you indeed a safe journey home. As you were reading my article, the once was a priest who gave the shortest homily on Easter. Either you believe or you don't. Either you believe or you don't.
one of the churches on riot sums up very well what Easter is all about. It says the greatest message of Easter is the empty tomb, and indeed it is. So as we celebrate this Eucharist, as we celebrate this Vigil night, may we give praise to God. May we be like Peter and the women in today's gospel who saw, who were amazed, who believed, because the one who was thought to be dead is no longer dead. Dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which we sprinkle upon us as a memorial of our baptism. May he graciously renew us, that we may remain faithful in the Spirit whom we have received. Lord, you give us grace through sacramental signs and wonders, which tell us of your unseen power. In the waters of baptism, you sent down the Spirit. In the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery to the land of promise. In the waters of the Jordan, Jesus was baptized, and the Holy Spirit dwelt upon him. O Lord our God, we ask you to send your Spirit upon the waters of this font. May those who are baptized in it be ever mindful of the Spirit you sent upon the apostles at Pentecost. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so we may walk with him in newness of life. And so, now that our Lenten observance is completed, let us renew the promises of our baptism, by which we once renounced Satan's works, and promised to serve God and his holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, you renounce Satan,
I do.
And all his works,
I do.
And all his empty promises.
I do.
You believe in God the Father, Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth.
I do.
You believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father.
I do.
You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body and life everlasting.
Amen.
And may Almighty God, the Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Jesus Christ our Lord for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
asked to be received into full communion of the Catholic Church. You have made your decision after careful thought under the guidance of the Holy Spirit. I now invite you to come forward with your spouse. In the presence of this community, to profess the Catholic faith is a faith you will be one with us for the first time at the Eucharistic table of our Lord Jesus Christ, the sign of the Church's family. May the Lord receive you into the Catholic Church. His loving kindness has led you here, so that in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you may have full communion with us in the faith that you have professed in the presence of his family. I'd like to invite the other catechumens to come forward, please. My dear candidates for confirmation, by your baptism you have been born again in Christ. You have become members of Christ and his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit sent the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them in their successors to the baptized, the promised strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, will make you more like Christ and help you to be witnesses of his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the Church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and in love. My dear friends, let us pray to God the Almighty Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on these candidates for confirmation, to strengthen them with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. All-powerful God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send forth your Spirit upon them, that they may be helpers and guides. Give them the Spirit of right judgment and wisdom, understanding and courage, the Spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the Spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Be sealed in the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. May be sealed with the Holy Spirit. Elizabeth, be sealed in the Holy Spirit. William, be sealed in the Holy Spirit. Luke, be sealed in the Holy Spirit.
Spirit. Joseph, be sealed with the Holy Spirit. Well, congratulations. Our needs and our petitions, and indeed our thanksgivings in the hands of the loving Father.
For the church, may we all radiate the light of Christ each day and live as daughters and sons of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who find themselves walking in darkness or doubting their faith, may they encounter the risen Lord who brings light to their journey and peace to their hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For healing of hearts and relationships, that the risen Lord will open the path to reconciliation and healing in families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, that Christ will heal the sick and give strength to those facing an extended recovery. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died, may Christ welcome them into the eternal life and joy of God's presence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
With joyful hearts, Lord, we present these requests at your altar, along with the petitions from our prayer box and websites, and the personal prayers we carry within. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious and loving God, you know our hearts and our prayers long before we voiced them. In your love and in your mercy, may they be granted through you, we ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join in singing the song of presentation, which is number 520. This is the Feast of Victory, number 520.
Thank you.
Except we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in this Paschal mysteries, made by the working of your power, become for us the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Lift up your heart.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this holy night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. By dying he restored our death, by rising he restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalt in your praise. In the heavenly powers, sing forever to your glory without end, we acclaim. Supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Giving thanks, you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Helen, our Bishop, and all those who serve and minister to your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, her husband, the blessed apostles, St. Jane Francis, and all your saints, who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the courage to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always freed from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. In grace, they grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of peace. God, the only who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the suffering.
Thank you.
loving God on this Easter night, may we indeed celebrate the resurrection of your Son. And may we, like the disciples, proclaim him as risen from the tomb. We ask all of this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.